Hello my dear friends. This time let's talk about vitamin D and what vitamin D does. Vitamin D is the only vitamin, and this vitamin is a hormone. The primary job of vitamin D is to maintain normal blood levels of calcium and phosphorus. The task of vitamin D is to make sure the calcium and phosphorus are absorbed from the intestines. Vitamin D makes sure calcium and phosphorus are available to create and maintain strong bones. Vitamin D also works with many other vitamins and minerals to promote the building of bones. Without vitamin D, bones can become brittle, thin, or misshapen. So where do we get vitamin D? The source of vitamin D. Vitamin can be made in the body. This is the significant difference between vitamin D from other vitamins. First, sunshine is a significant source of vitamin D. When you are in the sunshine, the ultraviolet rays shine on your skin. A cholesterol-like compound in the body is converted into a precursor of vitamin D and absorbed into the blood. This precursor is converted into the active form of vitamin D. The body gets most of its vitamin D from the skin, not from food. A light-skinned person needs only about 10 minutes of sunshine on the face, hands, and arms 2 to 3 times per week to make enough vitamin D. A dark-skinned person needs more time in the sun because the melanin in the skin acts as sunscreen. Melanin is a dark brown to the black pigment in the skin. It takes about 10 to 20 minutes of sun exposure to make enough vitamin D for the day. However, too much sun exposure may cause skin cancer, so sunscreen is used by many people. Nevertheless, even with a sunscreen with SPF up to 30, people will make enough vitamin D with 20 minutes of sun exposure. Another source of vitamin D is supplements. Third, a good source of vitamin D is fatty fish such as salmon and mackerel. Egg yolks also contain some vitamin D. Other significant food sources of vitamin D are foods fortified with the vitamin. The foods fortified with vitamin D are exampled as the following. 1. Vitamin D fortified butter and margarine. 2. Vitamin D fortified orange juice. 3. Vitamin D fortified cereals. 4. Vitamin D fortified milk. The next question is, am I getting enough vitamin D? Vitamin D deficiency in children causes rickets. Rickets is a childhood disease in which bones do not grow normally, resulting in bowed legs and knocked knees. This disease, rickets, is generally caused by a vitamin D deficiency. In adults, vitamin D deficiency causes osteomalacia. Osteomalacia is a disease in which bones become soft and painful. Osteomalacia softens bones in adults due to a lack of vitamin D. Vitamin D deficiency can also contribute to and worsen bone disease named osteoporosis. This disease often is seen in older adults, especially women. Fragile bones characterize osteoporosis with low bone mass, which is more likely to break. In other words, osteoporosis is a disease characterized by loss of bone density and strength so that bones may break easily. Osteoporosis is more common in women than men, especially in people 50 and older, due to a tremendous loss of bone tissue in midlife. Having normal storage levels of vitamin D in the body is one of several strategies needed to keep bone strong. Older adults are at increased risk of a vitamin D deficiency because as people age, skin cannot synthesize vitamin D as efficiently as the skin of younger people. The last question is, can vitamin D be harmful? The answer is positive. Do not overconsume vitamin D. Overconsumption of vitamin D occurs when individuals take high-dose vitamin D supplements, usually over a long period. Excess vitamin D can lead to calcium deposits in the heart, blood vessels, and kidneys that can cause health problems. In summary, vitamin D is a vital substance. It maintains normal blood levels of calcium and phosphorus and makes sure the calcium and phosphorus are available to create and maintain strong bones. However, do not over-intake or consume vitamin D. Overconsumption can lead to health problems. Sutasty Kanda made this video. Thank you for watching. Please stay tuned. In the following video, we will talk about another essential fat-soluble vitamin, vitamin E, an antioxidant in our cells, to reduce the risks of heart disease and cancers. See you in the following video.